In this video, we're going to go through how you can build a content curation website using no-code tools. We'll go through the idea behind the content curation website, the tools that you need in order to do this, and also go into the steps that you need to take in order to make the design. We'll talk about how to monetize this type of website, how to bring in traffic and new users to the site, and then we'll look at some examples to inspire you. Now, if you want other business ideas using no-code tools, then just go to the description and we'll leave a list of the other videos we've made on this topic. If you are new here, or if you haven't done so already, subscribe to the channel for future videos. And while you're in the description, check out our free guide and also a link to our premium courses, including a course with step-by-step instructions of how to create this type of website using Webflow. So, a content curation website. What is this and why is it useful for people? So this is a platform that gets content from elsewhere and puts it all onto one website in an organized way. So the content can be anything from favorite tools, blog posts, podcasts, news, you name it. And by choosing a particular niche, the website can become the go-to source for anybody who wants to learn more about this subject. And all of this will make sense as we go through the video and look at different examples. But you'll need to decide on the niche that you want to choose. Actually, let's look at one example now to help you understand this a little bit better. Here is a website called Nomad List. And what it does is it gives you information on different cities and countries where you can work as a nomad. And it does this by getting information from other websites and different sources, and also from people who submit content to the website. And it goes through things like cost of living, for example, in this case, in Bangkok, the pros and cons of moving to this city, the weather, so weather at different times of the year, and lots of other things to help you decide which city you want to move to if you want to become a nomad. And as you can see, people who want to become a nomad will go to this website as their source to learn about different cities and where they should move to. Like I say, we'll look at some more examples later, but now let's talk about the design of the site and also which tool to use in order to build it out. Now, at No Code MBA, we really like the tool called Webflow when it comes to designing websites, because it gives you complete control over the design and the dynamic elements that you want to introduce. Now, we do have a full tutorial on Webflow, over 7 hours of videos that goes through how to build different websites using Webflow and how to use this tool in general. And there is a tutorial on how to build a content creation website using Webflow. But just to give you an overview here of what is involved in building a website like this, where in this example, we're going to be highlighting specific tools for marketers or people who have a business online. So tools like analytics, web design tools, etc. And in order to do this, first, we go into the content management system and create categories for the different categories of tools. And then also we add in the different tools as well. So let's just say MailChimp, ActiveCampaign, HubSpot, etc. These are the tools, and the categories might be email marketing software. Now, doing this allows for dynamic pages, meaning that you can create a page, and when you add a new tool, it'll automatically add that to that page in a dynamic way. And then from there, you can add in the different categories and tools as like the dynamic page, create those pages, style the pages, so you give it the look of the font, the colors, and also just the way it looks on screen. And then what we can do is then go into the tablet and the mobile option and then make changes to make sure that everything looks right on the right device. There are other ways to do this. You can use WordPress, you can use other website builders, but Webflow is one of the best ways to do this in the most custom way without using code. So you can see, if we build a website that has online tools for digital marketers, then this website can become the authority in this area, and people will visit the website in order to learn about the best tools. You can even use elements like upvote and downvote so it becomes more of a democratic website, or you can simply just do it according to what you believe is the best tool and also add in different features so that people learn about which tools are best for who. Now, once the website is designed, there are two main things we need to do here. Firstly, decide how we're going to monetize it, and then secondly, create strategies to bring users to the website. Now, when it comes to monetizing, if you are doing something like tools, then most of these tools are going to have affiliate links. And this means that if somebody clicks onto the tool from your website and then gets the software or signs up to a subscription, then you're going to receive a percentage of that sale. And most tools and online programs now have affiliate programs because it's a great way for them to make more sales. Now, another way you can monetize is having advertisements on the page. And we can use things like Google Ads here. So you can embed Google Ads onto your website. And the way that this works is when somebody clicks one of those advertisements on your website, then you're going to receive a specific amount of money for that. Now, how much you receive depends on the type of ad, the industry, where the user is, and this varies greatly. But the idea with Google Ads is that you're going to need quite a large amount of visitors in order to make this work in a profitable way. And a third way to monetize is to promote featured content. So you can reach out to companies, let's say if you're doing tools again, and ask them, hey, would you like your tool to be featured at the top for this price? That is going to help them make more sales. And if the return is there for them, then they're going to be open to this. So we've talked about how to build out the tool and also how to monetize. Let's talk about how we can bring people to the website. Now, in the way that you can build out the website using Webflow, then when people search and filter, this is going to create specific pages with the URL as well. Now, when you do this, you're adding more content to the website, and this is going to get picked up by search engines. Now, this video is not going to go into too much detail when it comes to search engine optimization, but the idea here is that when you create content that is searchable, then people are going to find you through search. And then other ways to bring in people through content marketing is to create a Twitter account for the website, to create a YouTube channel for the website, Instagram account, etc. And let's just say you're again doing tools, then you can post about these tools on Instagram and on the other platforms that I've just mentioned. And then you include a call to action to then go to the website to learn more about that tool and other tools that are available based on that category. You can also guest blog on other platforms too, where you write an article on a similar website in the same industry. And this article is going to help that website because it's more content for the website, but it's also going to benefit you because then you link back to the website you've just built. And this does two things. It brings in people directly from that website, but it also helps with search engine optimization because it's a backlink to your site and Google likes quality backlinks. And then you can also post in relevant online communities. So let's say you're doing a content creation website which has events in your city, then you can go onto Reddit and find a subreddit which is related to the city and talk about events in that subreddit. Become an authority voice in that subreddit, and then, without spamming, link to your website. Now let's look at some examples. This is atlantamusicguide.com, and this is a content curation site because what they do is they take music events, and I'm not sure exactly how they design the website and how they bring in the content, but basically it's a one-stop shop for people who are interested in music in Atlanta. And what it does is it shows the different events that are happening this week and events that have happened recently. And you can see there's got a concert calendar here, which is very useful for people visiting. And you'll also notice that they have adverts on the website too. So they've embedded Google Ads here so that they can bring in revenue if somebody clicks on one of these adverts. And then insider.ai has a directory. And this is where they are listing the different tools for AI. So you can see here, you can toggle onto audio and it's going to list the different tools here. For them to monetize, they might feature a specific tool. And then these are perhaps affiliate links. So again, if we want to get Synthesia and we go try now and we sign up, perhaps what's going to happen is that this website and the person behind it is going to receive a percentage of that sale. And alltop.com is one where it brings in the top news stories from different websites and newspapers. And it does this through the RSS feed. So it automatically embeds that content onto the website from the RSS feed. And that's a way to automate this process if you're building a content curation website. You can see here that they have advertisements on their platform too. So let us know your thoughts. What content curation websites do you like? Do you have an idea to build one? And if so, definitely check out the course that we have on Webflow. I'll leave a link to that in the description because it goes through what we discussed before when it comes to the CMS, styling the pages, and creating the pages in general. And it goes into that in depth so you can get everything set up really quickly. Again, if you're new here, subscribe to the No Code MBA YouTube channel. Check out the free guide in the description. Check out the courses too. And if you want to stay on YouTube, then watch another one of our videos. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye for now.